everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I hope everyone is doing great and stay safe wherever you are, and always remember to keep the social distancing whenever you go out. So in the previous lesson, we have learned about the posture, the breathing and the warm-ups for singing. So these three things are very important because it could affect the sound produced by a vocalist. So we need to keep on practicing again and again, so our body and voice are used to adapting the new things. The same thing applies to what we are going to learn today. So before we start our lesson, we are going to do some vocal exercises from the previous lesson. The first one is the hissing exhale. The second one is the lip trills. And then lastly, the bubble exercises, which is the ma, me, mi, mo, mu. Okay, let's do this together. The third one is ma me mi mo mu, okay? Ma me mi mo mu. 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 So what makes some people such a good singers while others aren't? Speaking is a natural part of human communication. So why doesn't this always translate into singing abilities? So well, there are a few things that we need to concern about. For starters, the sound you produce are products of your vocal cords, larynx and other components of the throat. Some people are more naturally suited to vibrating their vocal cords in a nice way. For other people, it takes practice and practice, and there's nothing wrong with that. So to start doing this, we need to understand some things about how human singing works. So today, we are going to learn about the vocal registers. So what are vocal registers? A register is a set of tones that your voice can produce at roughly the same quality and in the same way. If you start low in your range and try to sing a straight line of notes into the upper registers, you should be able to feel when you switch from one register to the next, because your larynx shift and your vocal cords vibrate differently. And you may even experience a register break, which is a point at which it becomes very difficult to sing as you transition between register. And these breaks can be just one note or several that when sung are some of the most difficult notes in your range to produce well. So our vocal cords are a muscle, and just like any muscle in your body, they can be stretched and strengthened. Extending your overall range involves you stretching your vocal cords, and strengthening your breaks involves the same thing. So what are the four vocal registers? There are four types of vocal registers, starting from the highest to the lowest pitch. They are falsetto, head voice, mixed voice or the middle voice, and the chest voice. So what is falsetto? Most of the modern musicians use it to describe the highest metal register that a male vocalist can reach. With this way, a man's highest vocal notes could mimic those within a female's head voice range. Women are also able to use this technique to sing at an even higher pitch. But what makes falsetto different from other high pitch singing methods, like say the head voice register? Well, the thin edges of the throat muscle or the vocal folds in the larynx create the unique falsetto tone when from the lungs blows past them. In addition, the falsetto sound comes only from the head, which puts less pressure on the throat in comparison to other vocal registers. But the downside is that the falsetto technique produces fewer overtones than the head voice, which tends to sound fuller and ring out for longer. So let's check this video out and listen to the falsetto style. So the second voice register is the head voice. Head voice is a lower pitch vocal range than both the falsetto and the whistle register, but is brighter and lighter sounding than the chest voice. So this head voice is also the most popular singing among the musician. The main difference between the falsetto and head voice is that the falsetto requires an open glottis, while the head voice lets the vocal folds narrow. Falsetto can also be breathy and hollow. The head voice projects a more balanced resonance. So generally, women don't notice as much difference between the head voice and chest voice, while men often use falsetto as their head voice for more impact. But how do we know that we are singing using the head voice? So to do so, place your hand on the top of on the top part of your head, commonly referred to our crown, and simply humming. You can feel the vibration moving to the top of your head. Another way is placing your hand at the back of your neck. So when you hum, you can clearly feel the vibration of the sound move from your throat in a sequence that ends with you feeling it in your head. So it goes through your throat, mouth, and ends up as the vibration of the chords you feel. Hence, this is the head voice. So let's check out the next video and listen to the example of the use of the head voice. Walking in the air, we're floating in the moonlit sky. The people far below are sleeping as we fly. the third one is the mix or the middle register. Mixed voice is the blending of the chest and the head voice. So it is also the elimination of the gap that connects the two registers. So when a singer sings properly using this mixed voice, it could sound very loud and very chesty, leading an audience to believe that the singer is belting a high note in the chest voice. So once a vocalist master the art of moving smoothly through this transition area, they are considered capable of mixing or blending the other registers surrounding the range. So for some singers, for example, Celine Dion, Michael Jackson, Beyoncé, they were born naturally using this mixed voice. So let's check out the next video and listen to the example of mixed voice. And lastly, the chest voice. What is the definition of chest voice? The very simple explanation is that chest voice is that low to middle part of your voice, in the same range where you speak. It's usually an easy part of the voice to sing in, although for women it could sometimes be more difficult. Also, this chest voice is the lowest part of your vocal range. So technically, your vocal folds are vibrating across their entire length when you are singing with chest voice. So the term chest voice comes from the sensation you feel in your chest when you are using it. So try to put your hand on your chest and strongly say you probably will feel some vibration in your chest area. So each of us has a different vocal instrument, and how low and deeply you can sing it in your chest voice will depend on what type of voice you have naturally. So let's make a comparison between Adele and Ariana Grande. Between Adele and Ariana Grande, Adele has a much thicker and darker chest voice compared to Ariana. However, this is not to say that deeper voice is always better. For example, a violin could sound more beautiful compared to the cello, even though violin doesn't have the same depth of sound. So same goes when we are comparing the voices. So let's check out the next video and listen to how the chest voice sounds like. So that's all for today. Let's do a little recap. Before we start to learn, we practice three of our vocal warm-ups, which is the hissing exhale, the lip trills, and the vowel exercise. And after that, we learn about what are the vocal registers, and there are four types of vocal registers. There are falsetto, head voice, mix or the middle voice, and the chest voice. So no doubt, these vocal registers are quite challenging to master, especially when most of us feel more comfortable using our single strongest register. Like for me, I personally get used to chest voice when singing. So I hope you really enjoy this video and don't forget to practice, because practice makes perfect. See ya, bye!